Hey guys, how are you doing? So I decided to just sit on my couch here, be comfortable, and do a video. It is St. Patrick's Day. I did not upload a video on Tuesday. Today is Wednesday, so I will be doing several videos today. Remember, if you're new to my channel, because a lot of you are just now subscribing, I upload videos on YouTube every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday at 11 a.m. Central Standard Time. I've been so busy over the last like 5 days that I have fallen behind on social media. However, I'm back on track and I am happy to be here to assist you. And yesterday I got a new client. And it's just such a blessing to get new clients, people who actually invest their hard-earned money to hear what you have to say so you can guide them and coach them and teach them things. And it was a young lady, and we mentioned in the phone call of something about boundaries. And I'd already had my list of, excuse me, I have allergies in there on my nerves. I already have my list of 25 video ideas that I wanted to do. And on this list of video ideas, and here, I'll show it to you guys. It's right here. That's my list. And on here, I had boundaries. Boundaries is so important to women who are dating. I can attest to this. When I was, it was years ago, where I had this guy that I liked, and I knew that my boundary was sex. I knew that I was not going to have sex with this guy. And I knew that that just wasn't going to happen. That was my boundary. And not just him, just any dude. And so a lot of times, ladies, when we're dating, we don't set those boundaries up front. We wait for that boundary to be pushed or that line to be crossed. And we're all out of bounds and all out of the boundaries. And we're having a kiki good time. And then we think about it and we know that's not what we want in our gut. However, we just somehow went with the flow with it and just jumped in. And now we want to try to go back and set boundaries. That doesn't make sense. You're out of order. So if you find yourself in this situation, just it is what it is. If you're in a situation where you know you didn't want to do house calls. I talk about this in my book, Hello, My Name is Single. No house calls when you're first dating a guy. If you know that you don't want to do house calls, but yet he somehow manages to come up with a reason why you should come to his house or why he should come to your house, and you know that's not really what you want, but you do it anyway because fear is in you, and you're scared that if you say, well, I don't do house calls, that he may not want to talk to you anymore. So you go along to get along. However, the more he comes over your house, the more you never go outside of the house, and the more he comes over your house and you go over to his house, things get a little bit more touchy-feely, and you already know that you don't want to have sex with him without a commitment. So now here we are pushing another boundary, and it's a domino effect. So if you're in that situation, there is a way out. However, if you've already gone beyond your boundary and you're trying to reel it back in and he is full of resistance, that is okay. That just means he's not your guy. If he is unwilling to back it up, slow it down, and regroup and do things in a different way, then that means he's not your guy, and that is okay. And I need for you to know that it is okay by letting him go and setting him free. So think about it. When you're in the beginning of a new relationship, excuse me, and you know your boundaries, make them clear. That don't mean go to your date with a list like this and say, these are my boundaries, you bet not cross it. No. It's when you feel like it's approaching that in conversation. For instance, on the first date, if you know you don't do house calls, in that first conversation, you say, well, when I'm getting to know someone and we're dating, I would prefer that we do public dates and like at the park. That doesn't mean he has to cash out on me. That just means we can go to the movies, we can go to the park, we can go ice skating, we can go roller skating, we can ride bikes. There is abundance of things that I like to do outside of the house. We can go to a cooking class, because for me to be comfortable, I'm uncomfortable with someone that I'm just dating being in my house, excuse me, or me being in their house. See? You set the boundary. You did it in a light way. You weren't confrontational. You just let your boundary be known. So do this, ladies. Next time you find yourself in a sticky situation because you did not set boundaries, don't get down on yourself. Learn from that experience and apply it to the next experience. All right, guys. I'm going to be Wiley here every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday with a new video. Today's video is different because it's Wednesday, but I didn't do a video yesterday. So here you go. I'm trying to hold myself accountable. I am holding myself accountable. So I'm so glad you're here. And if you made it this far, please feel free to hit the notification bell, subscribe, so you'll know when I'm online. And feel free to comment below. What kind of other videos do you want to talk, want me to talk about? Because I specialize in breakups, communication, and of course, dating tips and tools and tricks. I'll let you know everything I got. All right, guys, I'll talk to you later.